like Spinoza insists is to act virtuously.
He's talking about Judaism. You know?
Living by the guidance of reason, we necessarily place ourselves at odds with others. Reason prescribes that individuals seek whatever aids in the striving for perseverance.
Right.
Since the goods that are necessary in order to persevere in being are attainable only within the context of social life, reason dictates that we act in ways that are conducive to the stability and harmony of society.
Yes.
As opposed to far as to say that in society in which everyone lives by the guidance of reason, there would be no need of political authority to resist or to restrict. It is only insofar as individuals live under the sway of the passions, they come into conflict with one another, and are in need of political authority. Those who live by the guidance of reason understand this and recognize the authority as legitimate.
That's why they're so stupid, you know? But his concept states that human beings' natural inclination is to strive toward preserving an essential, or essential being, and an assertion, the virtue, human power, is defined by success in the preservation of being by the guidance of reason as one central ethical doctrine, which would be God. Or not the ethical doctrine, but the guidance of reason would be God. According to Spinoza, the highest virtue is the intellectual love or knowledge of God, natural, and universe, which is all the same. Or God, nature, and universe. So it's very almost transcendental. I haven't read Ethics, but he's talking about true blessings and preservation and, you know. But what I don't understand and what I don't agree with is I don't understand why in Judaism you've got the preservation of life, and you've got, which is important, I understand that, and then you've got compassion, which is, I think compassion is important. But I don't understand why there has, or why peace is not always the absence of violence. And that's when we go into war, and we go into what is, or in catharsis, you could say it's catharsis, because the absence of violence, you know, what does violence have to, why does violence have to be an extension of peace? You know, why does violence have to accompany peace? That's when things become violent, you know, that gives well, we're just trying to find peace. We're over here in this land taking away this mother's milk and stripping the baby from her breast, and we're knocking down this house and burning this field of wheat, and we're burning these palm trees, you know, these date palm trees, and we're taking away these different types of fruit so that we can establish peace. So there has to be violence so that we can make the peace here. So I'm sorry, we want to preserve life. We are compassionate. We want to win your hearts and mind. We want to win your hearts and minds, but we have to have violence.
From here, it is but an easy step to show that knowledge of God is the mind's greatest good.